consider section overhead and the CM1 payroll. Can you write this in your diagram? We miss his name.
No?
CM1 payload. That is what we call VC. CM1 payload is equal to VC. So include that name. This one we call point, and for that AU 4 point, that's the name. AU stands for administrative unit. Can you correct it? We did not mention AU. Make a note that this pointer here is pointing to the starting byte of VC4. VC4 can start anywhere, naturally it may start here. But there is a byte number. That number will have to be stored here. That is called a pointer. So the starting point will be pointed by this number. That's why it is called a pointer. One of the pathways that they have asked the point also, so we will know that. AU stands for administrative unit. AU stands for administrative unit. But we did not write any set. The starting point is naturally here, but it is possible that if your ATM signal started here, it is possible that it may be anywhere. From there, we see spoken sense. So that is why the point is, which means that we see four could start at any point within the STM1 pair. Let us try and move. VC4 could start from anywhere, could start from anywhere within the STM1 payload, anywhere within the STM1 payload space. STM1 payload space. Space, SPSE. However, the address of that starting point could be stored. So in the AU4 administrative unit 4 pointer, AU4 location, in the AU4 location, for example. The first 9 new paragraph, the first 9 columns consist of the SOH. Repeater section overhead, which is called multiplexer section overhead. N4 multiplexer, R4 repeat. But both are overhead. R means repeater. because there are optical repeaters. These optical fibers pass from repeater to repeater, there is an overlap. M is for multiplexer to multiplexer. So it is in two parts. Repeat over here, then? Not the center over here. Can write. However, okay, so it is in two parts. Okay, so it is in two parts. Namely, RSOS, RSOS and MSOS. RSOS and MSOS. RSOS from one optical repeater, from one optical repeater to the next optical repeater, one optical repeater to the next optical repeater in the transmission path. The transmission path. From one ADM. Which in bracket ad drop multiplexer from one ADM to the next ADM. One ad drop multiplexer to the next ad drop multiplexer. Next ad drop multiplexer in the transmission path. In the transmission path. Another virtual container before packing. But if you compare this with VDS, even line you can't directly pack it. You have to put into VC12 small container and then pack it. The ADM is directly supported. ADM can be directly packed without putting into another sub container. That's an important point. We will put a time mention. Can I note that ADM cells? That ATM cell can be directly packed without sending them, without packing them to a smaller VC4, smaller VC.
start packing them to a smaller VC, smaller virtual container.
Now, how do we receive this? On the receiving side, because the starting point may be not here, but maybe in the middle, there is a technique called deviation to find out the header. Because the last point of the header, if you remember the header here, what is the last point of the header? That time we said last point of the header was called the HTTP.
Header error control.
Header error
control.
And which is the error control byte of the first 4 bytes. There was a 5 byte header. Last byte was HTTP. First 4 bytes are put into some mathematical calculation to calculate HTTP. So same thing will be done in the receive. And if it finds, it will suspect that this is the start, do the calculation, answer it gets will be trying to match with the HTTP. If it takes a match, it knows that receiver knows that it has found the correct header. If they don't match, receiver finds that it has not found the first cell yet. So likewise, it will continue until it finds the first cell. After that, it counts every 53 bytes. So this idea we call header, delineation. Delineation means separating different ATM cells at the receiving. You can write new paragraph. At the receiving end, technique called cell delineation is used to identify the cell boundary. Cell boundary within bracket start and the stop. We know that the fifth byte of the header is the HTTP. Fifth byte of the header is the HTTP. Therefore, the first four bytes from the starting point, from the assumed starting point, first 4 bytes from the assumed starting point are put into the error calculation, and the answer is compared with the fifth byte. If they do not match, assume starting point is wrong. Then the process is repeated. Until the matching point
until a match, sorry, until a match is found. Match is found. So that way identifying stats of the first ATM cell is not a problem, right? You assume a certain place, do this calculation and check. If not, you advance your assumption, repeat. Likewise, you go on until you find the first HTC match. From there onwards, you can delineate or separate all the ATM cells. So that means there are no separate markers or synchronization bytes to be transmitted. You remember even how do you identify the start of the cell? You have to reserve one time slot for that. Synchronization time slot, special byte has to be sent. In ATM, you don't send any special byte. You save that bandwidth also. Because this error control technique can be used to find the starting point of the ATM cell. Once you find the starting point of the first ATM cell, you can keep counting 53 bytes and double checking again. That way you can completely separate all ATM cells. No separate framing required. So that makes it more efficient than even, because even needs all the synchronization bytes to be transmitted at the start of every cell. It needed multi-frame synchronization also. And here no synchronization or multi-frame synchronization need to be transmitted. Let us start. It is advanced. Because of this method, we do not need special synchronization by. Oh, marker by. Marker, M-A-R-K-E-R, marker by. In ATM. That's another important point. Because of this cell delineation technique, in E1 there was no such error checking. Therefore, this method cannot be used. But ATM is more efficient. One reason is delineation. Use a special algorithm. Using that technique, you don't need any additional, you don't need to reserve any additional bandwidth for synchronization. So that will be sufficient to answer the past phase. But one past paper, you will describe the Sonnet code. Not only SDA. So 1 year they have asked you to describe Sonnet. Sonnet is slightly different from SDA. Many things are same, but the size is different. So that I will give next time. I never thought that they will ask Sonnet. Because Sonnet is the American system. And we thought British will never ask it. Because they have their own SDA system. But however, one passive asks you to draw the Sonnet and how ATM can be loaded to Sonnet. So we will finish with that next time. We will start it there. Thank you.